Hi friends, today I'm going to show how to create Eureka server. So I'm going to create new Spring Starter project. I'm going to name it as Spring Cloud Netflix Eureka server. Part of packages com eclipse example.eureka. Click next. I need to add the dependence of cloud discovery, that is Eureka server and Eureka discovery, and click finish. So Eureka server provides service discovery and registration. So it itself, it can register for other applications like called as clients. It can register to the other client, and the client application can itself discover the other clients. So it provides both. So to make Eureka server, the boot application to run as a Eureka server, I have to add annotation called @enable Eureka server. Then it works as a Eureka server. Add the input statement. So when we add this annotation enable Eureka server, it works as a Eureka server. So I'm going to add some properties. I'm going to create application.yaml file. So I'm going to give server.port. The default port for Eureka server is 8761. And we want Eureka to instance host name. Then currently I'm running in localhost, so I'm giving the name of the host name is localhost. I have to give some other configuration, Eureka client.register. Client.register with Eureka. So you want to register this Eureka with the client, the server you want to register. So currently we want this as to run as a server, we don't want to register with itself. So I'm giving false. And similarly, Eureka.client.fetch, we want to fetch line dot fetch registry. So we want this not to register with itself, so the server will run only look for other application to register. It will not register with port itself. So now I'm going to run the application. Application started in port 8761. If I go to the Eureka server UI, this is the Eureka server UI. So localhost 87, it will be having the system status, what all the application it is registered, and the general info. So here currently it is not registered with any applications. And the host name, so it's giving the IP address of the machine and the status is up. So how this Eureka server will register the other client application is, it when you I'm going to show how to create how to register with Eureka server. So I'm going to, I have one student service application. I want this to be registered with Eureka. So to register with Eureka, I have to add enable with Eureka client. It's a client. I can use @ enable Eureka client or @ enable discovery client. I can use any of one annotation. So I'm using @ enable Eureka client. So when I add this annotation, It provides some metadata information like host name, IP address, and the health of the Eureka server. So it will be sent every time. It will be sending heartbeats from this server application to the Eureka server to check whether the application is up and running in the Eureka. And I'm giving the default the instance where the Eureka is running. Eureka.client. Service URL dot default zone. The service URL contains map of data, so we can give the preferences. If you have multiple instances of Eureka service, we can give here, but currently I'm having only one single instance, so I'm giving it as default zone. So http://localhost:8761/Eureka. So I'm going to start the application. See, this discovery client is initialized at this timestamp. So it is able to retrieve the client in the Eureka server. If you go to Eureka, here it is retrieved on the server. So it is registered. Client is discovered and the server is registered with this instance. By default, it uses the application name and the machine name colon spring application name and then the port. If we want, we can change using Eureka client dot instance dot instance ID. If I want to change this, I can use instance dot instance ID. I can use instance ID. I can give here, yeah. See, now the application is registered in the machine name and then application name and then port. So I'll restart. See, it was using this name, but it was not able to retrieve. It's dollar spring dot application. I have to use dollar, that's why it was not able to retrieve. If I go to here, we can see it will be like hard coded names. Yes, it was not able to retrieve the names. So I'm going to restart. So now the instance ID is changed. It is using random port. So the one which we are using, the one is down. It will take some default heartbeat is 30 seconds to remove from here. So the other one is the spring application name colon the random port. So this instance ID we can change. The default one will be the machine name colon application name colon port.